destroyer. Oh, damn. Doing that is not good for my throat. What's up, guys? It's me from HH here, and wow, would you look at that? I got 100 subscribers. I know it's not much, but for me, every milestone counts. Funny thing, I began this channel in 2010, and only now, 6 years later, I hit 100 subs. I mean, PewDiePie also began his channel in 2010, and he's already got over 40 million subs, while I just got 100. I think it's because he posts more quality content and more videos, but we're not here to talk about that. So, I wanted to do something different today to celebrate my 100 milestone, so I'm going to show you the characters that I have invented. I want to be a game maker, and I am making some games already. Go check them out again, Joel, if you want. My name there is the same as here. The characters that I made will be appearing specifically for these games, and I'm planning a very long and elaborate story that will combine all of the games I will make. So, let us meet my characters! First things first, let me just say that this list will be kind of long because I have invented 20 characters overall. Yes, each and every one of them will play an important role in the story one way or another, so all of the characters you'll see here are important somehow. I'll give you the picture, the name of the character, and some info about them. So, let's start! Let's begin with the main man. You see this guy? Yep, he's the main character of the story. His name is Bob Underhill. He's 1 year younger than I am now. In other words, he's 15. Well, most of the characters I invented are 15. Well, he can use magic and always fights to protect the world no matter what he's facing. He tends to be very egotistical sometimes, even though it's just for fun. He also loves hot dogs and baseball. He carries a bat with him, even though you can't see in this picture. Anyway, no more info, otherwise there will be spoilers for my games. Let's move on to the next. As with every main male character, there is some time in the story where he will get a girlfriend. In Bob's case, he already had one. This girl right here, her name is Natalie Calloway. She is also 15, even though she was born 1 month before Bob. She used to live in a different city where she had another boyfriend, but since he was way too much of a jerk, she broke up with him. Her family moved away to another city 1 week later, and in this new city, she met Bob. For some reason, she really likes to spin. Yeah, you know, ballerinas and spin tops? Exactly. She likes to do the same. I guess she'll be a ballerina when she grows up, huh? Anyway, next character. Every character has a friend that they can count on to call best friend. Same situation. This guy is called James Greenway. Even though he's 15, he is already working as a scientist and develops different machines every day. He was even smart enough to build a machine that replaced his right arm with a mechanical one. This arm has many functions. List something, the arm can do it. On school, he is obviously the one that always receives A+ on his exams and stuff. Well, the other stuff is going to be revealed through games, so I'm not going to say anything else because spoilers. Next character! I don't really like this one a lot, even though it's a character that I made. But here we go. It's another of Bob's friends and he's called Philip Ellenberg. I know he may be a fat guy, but trust me, he practices Kung Fu. He goes to a local gym where there are Kung Fu classes, and he trains there. He uses what he learns to help Bob on his fights whenever he might need any help. That's about all I can say about him. Next character! This guy's a tough one. And he looks cool, to me at least. Meet Lance Manchester. He is the only black guy character that I made, no racism intended. And he's also Bob's frenemy. They were best friends at childhood, but that changed one day. They became enemies, but after suffering a defeat from Bob, Lance apologized and became frenemies with Bob. Lance also can build robots that help him whenever he needs, though he doesn't build much. There are two important characters that I will reveal later that were made by Lance. Next character. This one is adorable. Also really cute. Wait, isn't that the same? Anyways, this little girl is called Sarah Underhill. As you might guess by her surname, she is Bob's sister. Little sister, to be exact. And the first one to have an age different from the others. She's just 5. Like Bob and Natalie, forgot to mention, she can use magic as well, but her magic is only focused on healing. It is very strong healing though, as she can heal any kind of wounds, unless they are fatal wounds. and she can also revive someone that died, as long as their body is in okay condition for revival. Next character! Just like the previous character that I have presented to you, this boy is also in his 5 years. His name is Will Calloway. Guessing by the surname, one would say that he is Natalie's brother. You're right! He can use magic powers just like his sister, although his powers and strength are much higher than Natalie's, because he is much more focused on his mission. Protect the ones he loves. That includes his family, his friends, his sister's friends, and especially Sarah, whom he has a crush on. Next character! Every story needs a villain, and I obviously wouldn't leave that out, of course. Meet Bob's doppelganger, Evil Bob. He has almost the same appearance, but he has quite a lot of difference in the personality. While Bob fights to keep peace in the world he lives, Evil Bob wants to destroy humanity and take over the entire universe. Yes, the universe! He has the power to do that, but he's always being stopped by Bob. So before he can accomplish his main goal, he has to eliminate his arch nemesis first. It is not an easy task, but who said Evil Bob would ever give up? He'll do anything necessary to make the universe belong to him. Next character! This guy might not be as important as the others, which is why I call him a secondary character, but he is important nonetheless. His name is Tom Williams. Remember a while ago when I said Philip practiced Kung Fu? Believe it or not, Tom is his Kung Fu teacher. He is a very skilled fighter and likes to pass his teaching to other people so that his fighting legacy can live on. Well, that's about all I can say about him. Next character. Vive la France! This guy is the second character that came from a different country, making me remember that I forgot to say that Tom is actually Russian. Anyway, this is Pierre Chevalier. He acts like a usual Frenchman. He has a French accent and likes to spend time with his best friend Tom. If anyone ever insults friends, Pierre will get seriously mad at that person and will react. Next character. Every villain needs a right hand. In this case, a right foot. Meet Illusion. He is a powerful demon of yet unknown species. Not only is he Evil Bob's best helper, he is also his pet. He really cares for his owner as Evil Bob really cares for him. He and Evil Bob share the same amount of hate for the same people. For example, Evil Bob really hates Bob. That makes Illusion really hate Bob too. He uses his very large feet to compensate the fact that he has no arms. Next character. Remember a while ago that there were two important characters that were invented by Lenz? This is one of them. It's Mechazord. He is the most functional machine that was ever invented by Lenz in his lifetime. No matter the challenges that he is given, he accomplishes it with ease. He was first built with the intention of defeating Bob, back when Bob and Lenz were enemies, but he failed. That was his first and only fail. Even though he's a robot, he has a gender. He is a male robot. Don't ask me how that works, it just works. Somehow. Next character! This is the other character that was invented by Lenz. Their name is Noob Clapper. Different from their partner Mechazord, Noob Clapper has no gender at all. Also different from Mechazord, Clapper is the least functional machine built by Lenz. They always fail the tasks they are given. But they never get sad with that. Noob Clapper is really cheery and likes to spend their time having fun instead of work. They are very tall and have very long arms and legs, but they are constantly bending them so that they can stay at the same height of other people. Next character! Let us have a change of pace. We are now traveling to a village made of fire, where there are inhabitants called Fire People. Their bodies, instead of being made 60% of water, it's made 60% of lava. That means the functions of lava and water are switched to them, and they can also use fire powers. With that said, meet the first guy, Fire Boy. I know, that name is not creative and there are millions of choices, but it was his parents that gave him that name. It's also easier to recognize. He's the only bald character that I made, if you count only the humans, but he has a flame on its place. He also is cheery, but sometimes he can be kind of annoying. He is easily embarrassed. Next character. Continuing on the Fire Village, let us meet the girls. This one is called Fire Girl. As you can already guess by the lack of creativity on her name, she is Fire Boy's twin sister. The crown on her head is a representation of beauty, as she was nominated the prettiest girl in the entire village. She is always positive, no matter the situation she's in. She also tries to cheer up her brother whenever he's in need. Remember when I say Fire Boy is easily embarrassed? Fire Girl causes most of those embarrassments, mostly because sometimes she taunts him, calling him things that represent weakness. Next character. Still on Fire Village, this one is the most skilled on the entire village. Meet Fire Ninja. Although ninjas are usually men, Fire Ninja is a girl. You can tell by the fire in form of a ponytail. She was born to a very poor family, which died before they could even name her. As a result, she is an unnamed orphan. She gave herself the name Fire Ninja after she went into the ninja business. The main reason why she is a ninja is to eliminate her enemies, Fire Boy and Fire Girl, after she discovered that it was their families who killed hers, and now she wants revenge. Next character. Let's go back to the city. There is another girl that you should meet. She's called Stacy Rogers. I know that she might be pretty and all, but I wouldn't get near her if I were you, because she has intentions cruel enough to make her another villain. She wants to kill everyone in the entire country. I know that might sound hard, but with her intelligence, speed, and agility, nothing is impossible for her. She commits many murders daily, but completely erases every evidence against her. No one's caught her, and no one could ever link her to any crimes. Ever. Next character. Let us bring out the rich ones. Here we have a gentleman called Harry Gentlestein. Complicated surname, huh? I know. Even though he acts like a gentleman, he's yet another villain. His initial plan was to cause the end of the world with the use of a doomsday device, but after he was stopped by Fireboy, he decided to start with something simpler yet evil, which is to cause the bankruptcy of every company in the country. He is always developing new plans, but Fireboy always stops him. Next character. I couldn't wait to talk about this one, because it's my personal favorite. She's the daughter of Harry, and she's called Melanie Gentlestein. She keeps the same surname, though. I really like her because she's cute, she's quiet, she likes cold seasons, she likes long hair, and she likes long clothes. In other words, she's basically a female version of me. But she has a difference. She suffers bullying because of her father's action. She doesn't tell anyone because the other adults are scared of her, since they link her to Harry. And she doesn't tell her father about it because she fears he might want to kill who bullies her, and that is not what she wants. Next character. Buenos dias, muchacho! Yep, here's another character from a different country, Alejandro Perez. As you can already tell, he is from Spain. He does not, I repeat, does not speak any language other than Spanish. Other people still understand what he says. He is one of those guys who gets all the ladies. He rides around on his horse, and whenever he finds a girl, he manages to charm her. He has a crush on Fire Girl, but she does not like him. Fireboy always defends his sister and has built a rivalry against Alejandro to compete if Alejandro dates Fire Girl or not. Very well, my friends. I do believe I am done. Those were the 20 characters that I have invented and hopefully will be successful in my future games. Let's not forget the reason I did this video, to celebrate my 100 subscriber milestone. Thank you everyone so much for getting me this far. I know 100 is a small number compared to what other YouTubers already have, but this is a start for me. Please keep supporting my videos. Like, share and subscribe to help my channel grow even more, because that will mean more content. Thanks again for 100, and I will see you guys in the next video. See ya!